And to that, I might also add in the context of Jammu and Kashmir Nyaya Dharma, which was actually the theme of the oath which was taken by Maharaja Hari Singh when he rose to the throne in 1925. And his opening speech was that hereafter I have no religion, my only religion is justice. And that is actually the religion which he was trying to explain. Religious not in the dogmatic sense of Hinduism, Islam, Krishna, because I have read Quran almost 10 times in classes. Bible I grew up reading. Bhagavad Gita was a home scripture. None of their scriptures actually advocate that kind of a dogmatic religion. So this religion which he was telling, I think was the best understood by someone like Maharaja Hari Singh, who also happened to be a son of soil like Professor Bhatia. I think it was somewhere in the March 2019. Many of us were actually engaged that time. We were trying to do an exercise related to Article 370, one way or the other. So I was sitting with Mr. Arun Jaitley. He was also doing an exercise of sorts on this subject, which of course has been his forte all his life. So he asked me, could I have some reference where we could find a comparative correlation between the law as it exists in the Indian constitution vis-a-vis as it is there in the separate constitution of Jammu and Kashmir. And you'll be pleased when I tell you that almost single breath and simultaneously, I said Professor Bhatia and he also said Bhatia. And soon thereafter, about half an hour later, I called him up. I said, I have a book of yours, but I just want you to precisely send me those three or four pages, actually there are two chapters of comparison. That here is an academician who has evolved with a unidirectional approach, a very focused approach, not allowing his hard-earned glory to be tempted by extraneous considerations. And that gives him a place which is distinct from all others. And now as far as the books written by him are concerned, the elections in J&K used to get so rampantly rigged that there was a time when there came to be two classes of MLAs known outside Jammu and Kashmir. One was Janta MLAs, who were elected from Jammu region. Others were Khalik MLAs, the Khalik famous DC, Deputy Commissioner, Deputy Commissioner Srinagar, then Dear Soil Doda. So before the closing time of nominations, he would reject all the other papers and accept only the National Conference nomination. And finally, entire National Conference would get elected unopposed. So he got so skilled in this exercise, and the Election Commission of India's jurisdiction had not extended to Jammu and Kashmir by then. So Arunji mentioned that, Khalik MLAs, and he just wanted to check on me. And therefore I am glad that Kishori Bhatia has also ventured into that exercise, which many of us actually had been into for many years. Particularly of the next generation in academics, in the business of writing, also tend to ape the social media trends rather than, you know, to indulge in a serious exercise. So you find them dropping names or being critical about a big name, because that would attract the reader. When you don't have the confidence that your article or column would be read, you put a caption abusing a big leader so that people come and read it. So that kind of thing happening